A Milwaukee man gives up his career to bring relief to an African nation, and local students are stepping in to help out.
Tonight, Patrick Paolantonio reports on the lengths they're going to for a country where the average age is 44 and the average income is about a dollar a day.
On one of the coldest mornings of the year, Samson Kawari finds something more familiar, an image playing back in a Milwaukee living room.
Very nice to meet you. Are you having fun out here today?
The video shows his two worlds, his fellow Tanzanians working and learning side by side with his fellow students from Marquette University.
Because sometimes it's very difficult to explain. People will ask you, how is it in Tanzania? How do you feel like living in Tanzania?
Adam Stout and Adrian DePoor have a better idea.
Hey, Adrian.
Hey.
Their group from Marquette just returned.
These people don't, like, a lot of them don't have electricity, don't know where they're going to get their food from, don't know how they're going to have a job.
During a couple of weeks traveling the country, they dropped off medical supplies, worked at an orphanage, and at one point helped build a school. The local mason, they say, had limited tools.
He had one shovel and three spades to build two buildings, plaster the walls, mortar the ceiling.
Tanzania for these two wasn't even on the radar until they met Ryan Scaife.
Morogoro is the sister city with Milwaukee.
Ryan is a photojournalist. He left his career to create hope in Tanzania. The idea is to bring American know-how to the country in the form of medical care, education, and agriculture.
They have enough people and the resources. They just need the knowledge and the technology to catch up to what we're doing.
What he's doing is reaching out to corporations, the community, and the education field here, trying to get their help overseas.
It's a very addictive nation.
Once you go there, you're just like, I gotta go back.
Now that they've seen it and know what's needed, the students plan to collect and send over more supplies.
So even if, you know, we get little gifts from here to go there and help out, that means more people can volunteer because now they have tools to build their schools, which is, of course, is very important because once you provide people with education, you know, you help them a lot. So.
A bond they believe will grow even stronger, making an impact on people there and here. In Milwaukee, Patrick Paolantonio, WISN, 12 News.
And there's another local connection to Tanzania. Former Wisconsin Congressman Mark Green is the U.S. ambassador to that country.